There's also another way to compute the dot product, and we'll show you how to get it from the formula length of u times length of v times cosine of theta. So first, we know that if we complete this triangle, then we have, and we call this theta, let's call this A, then we have by the law of cosines, the length of A squared equals the length of u squared plus the length of v squared minus the length of u minus 2 times the length of u times the length of v times cosine of theta. So we can simplify this in some way. Well, u squared, the length of u, is u1 squared plus u2 squared. And that's the square root. That's going to be squared plus the length of v, which is v1 squared plus v2 squared, minus 2 times, and we're going to leave these two the same, length of u, length of v, cosine theta. Alright, so we have the length of A squared equals u1 squared plus u2 squared plus v1 squared plus v2 squared minus 2 times the length of u times the length of v cosine theta. Well, what else do we know about this vector right here? Well, we know that we can write it as the vector A is equal to the vector v minus the vector u. So that means that the vector A is v1 minus u1, v2 minus u2. So the length of A is the square root of v1 minus u1 squared plus v2 minus u2 squared. So the length of A is the square root of v1 squared minus 2u1 v1 plus u1 squared plus v2 squared minus 2 u2 v2 plus u2 squared. So simplifying, that's what we got. So now up here we had the length squared. So if we square both sides, we have v1 squared minus 2 u1 v1 plus v1 plus u1 squared plus v2 squared minus 2 u2 v2 plus u2 squared, and that is equal to this over here. It's equal to u1 squared plus u2 squared plus v1 squared plus v2 squared minus the length of u minus 2 the length of u length of v cosine theta. Doing some cancellations, we have v1 squareds cancel, u1s cancel, v2s cancel, and u2s cancel, leaving us with negative 2 u1 v1 minus 2 u2 v2 equals negative 2 length of v cosine theta. And the negative 2's cancel. So we're left with u1 v1 plus u2 v2 equals the length of u times the length of v cosine theta. And both of these are equal to what we call the dot product, vector u dot vector v. So these are two separate formulas for computing the dot product, and this is how we define the dot product.